السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونؤمن به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وعوانه ومن والاه. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يكون اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مباركا تتنزل علينا رحمته والسكينة، ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا لسائر الخيرات في هذا الشهر المبارك. نرحب بضيوفنا الأجلة صاحب السمو الشيخ سالم بالركاد العمري والسيد أحمد محمد علي بن شبر والسيد خليفة زايد الكعبي والسيد عبد العزيز عبد الرحمن سالم العزيزي الفضلاء الأجلة بمناسبة شهر القراءة. أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أمة اقرأ، نستهز هذه الفرصة الليالي والأيام المباركة من هذا الشهر المبارك لننهل من دروس ديننا الحنيف ونبث الخير والبشر للإنسانية جمعا. Dear guests, His Highness Sheikh Salim Balrakad Al-Amiri, Mr. Sayyid Ahmed Muhammad Ali bin Shabr, Mr. Abdul Aziz Abdul Rahim Salim Al-Azizi, Mr. Khalifa Zayed Al-Ka'bi, Mr. Munir Chalil, the principal of Dalhuda Islamic School, Dr. Ibrahim, Mr. Ayub Khan, Sayyid Shihabuddin Tangal, Sayyid Hashim Tangal, and all the believers who gathered in the atrium of this school in the context of the month of reading. We have gathered to deepen our understanding of Quran, the divine revelation which has begun its first revelation by the word of Iqra. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the master of knowledge, who had been bestowed by the divine message from the age of 40 up to 63, illuminating and brightening the surroundings from the nooks and corners of the world, from cities to suburbs, civilization to civilization. We are blessed in this holy month of Ramadan, in the blessed nights and days. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we may attain the full benefits of fasting, an introspection, a self-check in this time. We all need to develop ourselves to attain the objective of fasting of Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. When fasting had been made compulsory, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala related fasting Ramadan by Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The reason why Ramadan is so sacred is nothing but Quran had been revealed in this holy month. And what is Quran? Quran is values. Quran is the morality. Quran is the source of ethics. Quran is the source of inspiration, the source of salvation. If you read Surah Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahman علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. Three ayats. Ar-Rahman, the most merciful. علم القرآن, taught Quran. خلق الإنسان, created man. علمه البيان, taught him eloquence. If you read the sequence of the ayah, we may think the order should change, like Ar-Rahman خلق الإنسان علم القرآن. Allah said, Ar-Rahman, Allama al-Qur'an, Khalaq al-Insan. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention the teaching of Qur'an first, followed by the creation of human beings? And the ulama and the scholars, like Allama Mutawalli Sha'rawi, rahimahullah, in his Khawatir, he has mentioned a very fascinating point that the purpose of a creation should precede the creation. The objective of anything that you create, you manufacture, should be first, then you create based on your objective. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sets the goal, the objective of creation first, which is allam al-Qur'an, ta'lim al-Qur'an, teaching Qur'an is the objective of the creation of humans. Then Allah mentioned allam al-Qur'an, khalaq al-insan, allamahu al-bayan. What a beautiful meaning. Eating, our shelter, our sleep and rest, these are all had been assured by Allah already. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. We are not to strive ourselves after food, hunting for shelter. Rather, that has been already secured for you from Allah. Your objective is to read Quran, to understand, to know the Creator, to cherish Allah, to do the ibadah, the worship, the way He wanted us to do. So when Allah mentioned شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, the first thing when we enter to Ramadan, we have to have our values ready. We have to have our قيم. We have to have our ethics, our morality, our sense of belonging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to have that ready in hand before we can enter to Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of Quran, the month of values. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Messenger of God, when he was out of his house, Sayyidatuna Aisha radiyallahu anha, the beloved wife and mother of the believers, she was asked, كيف كان خلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. How was the Messenger of God? What was his character like? What was his behavior like? What was his manners like? And she said, أَتَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنِ. Do you read Quran? And he said, yes, of course. كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His character was nothing but Quran. He was a living Quran. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما. When you read the qualities of the beloved slaves of Allah, you can see these characteristics apparent and shining within the characteristics of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was among those who yamshuna ala al-ardi hawna. He was those ma kana sukhaban bil aswaq, ma kana fahishan wala mutafahisha, kana mutawadi'an wa kanat al-aramil wal ayama يأخذون بيد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ويمشون به في سكك المدينة. That was Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was humble, down to earth. Any slave could hold on to his hand and tell him, O Messenger of God, I want you buy me this and that, and they would walk with him in the streets of Medina. Who would dare to walk and to ask
and to halt unto the hands of Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam for their sake. They wanted something to buy for them, and Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there always for them. So ad-deenu al-akhlaq, our religion is character, our religion is manners. If we cannot shape our behavior by our fasting, by our prayer, by our hajj and umrah, I think we would not be able to get into the core meaning of our religion. You remember the occasion when a woman was mentioned in front of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kanat sa'imatan qa'ima, and she was so well, you know, she was praying a lot, she would fast a lot, optional fasting, and she would do charities. But the only thing she did, وَكَانَتْ تُؤْذِي جِيرَانَهَا, and she would hurt her neighbors by her tongue. She would use foul language, she would use hurting words. The immediate answer came from the mouth of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was that هِيَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمْ, she would be among the dwellers of the hellfire. What does that mean? We, the ummah, the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, each one of us are representing this holy religion. Each one of us, we are representing the Quran, we are representing the message of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So anything, any mistake that we do in our dealings, in our interactions, in our words, in our sanctions, in our any type of behavior with any human beings, or let it be with nature, that will reflect badly on our religion. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say that kullukum ala thaghirin min thughuri hadha ad-din, we are all safeguarding this religion at its risky points. Fala yad'an ahadun aduwan yadkhulu min nahwi, so we should not let any enemy come through us from our place of watching, you know, where we are watching. We should not let anyone come into, sneak into this community. That means we don't let anyone to criticize our religion. We don't let anyone have a chance to think bad about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Messenger of Allah, or the Holy Quran. So my dear brothers and sisters, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. And what is Quran? It is guidance. What is hidayah? Hidayah is of two types. After a while, I'll be switching into Malayalam, inshallah. Hidayah, hudan linnas. Hidayah, guidance, is of two types. Number one, guidance from disbelief into belief. Guidance from dalala into hidayah. Guidance from ignorance into knowledge. Guidance from darkness to light, which we all have by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Born in Muslim families, we have been given faith by birth. So we are so lucky. Again, every day, 17 times, we ask Allah, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ آمِينَ. Surah Al-Fatiha has too many names. One of the names of Surah Fatiha is Surah Ta'leem Al-Mas'ala. This is the surah that will teach you how to ask Allah, how to pray, how to supplicate. And the only prayer available in this surah is اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, O Allah, guide us to the straight path. And we say سُرَاطُ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ, the path of those whom you have favored. غَيْرِ الْمَغْلُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ, not the path of those who earn your anger, your wrath. وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ, and not of those who went astray. We warn the straight path. Why should we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for hidayah every day? Do you know why? We are asking consistency in our hidayah. We're asking continuity in our hidayah. It may take a few seconds. Somebody can slip away from hidayah. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَا يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ حَرْفٍ. There are people who are worshipping Allah on the edge. There are some people on the edge. Easily they can slip away. Easily we can lose our hidayah. And it is the same way we can earn hidayah so quickly. Maybe this gathering, the hadith, and the history, the stories, the Quran that we're going to listen today, may make a greater impact on somebody else's life. Tonight, it may not take a few seconds for someone to enter to Hidayah. Stay firm in his Hidayah. It is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Talking about Imam Mahdi, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, who would be successing this ummah before the end time. Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told in a statement, يُصُّلِحُهُ اللَّهُ فِي يَوْمٍ وَلَيْلَةٍ. Allah will qualify him to lead the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam within a day and night. It wouldn't take too many years, too many months for someone to be a good person. So maybe this Ramadan could be the most influential Ramadan in somebody else's life. Maybe tonight's gathering, our lecture today, maybe this is having a greater impact upon our character building, upon our cleansing, upon our getting ready for our hereafter. Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala an. Let me come to another incident, a story about Imam Qa'nabi rahmatullahi alayh. Imam Qa'nabi, he is known to be one of the greatest scholar of hadith. Imam Qa'nabi reported from Malik ibn Anas rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, the Imam of Maliki Madhab, al-Madhab al-Maliki. Imam Qa'nabi, he was not a good man from his, in his young age. In his youth, he was drunk. He was drunk one day and he wore a red gown. He was right in front of house. He sees a mob, a group of people walking with a great sheikh. This man, he was in stunties, Imam Qa'nabi. He was not Imam Qa'nabi, he was Qa'nabi. A layman, a common, normal young man. Maybe he was an astray, he was not aware of Allah or Quran or Salah or Sawm, nothing. He was not practicing Islam at all. He sees a group of people walking by. He is asking, who are they? This is Shu'ba and his watalamiduhu and his disciples, his students. He's asking, who is Shu'ba? You don't know Shu'ba? This is Shu'ba ibn Hajjaj, the great scholar of hadith. What is hadith? Hadith is the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what he's doing? He's teaching hadith for people. Would he teach me hadith? Go and ask. So Qa'nabi walks, wearing his red gown. He was drunk. He was normal. He wasn't normal. He was abnormal. He comes closer to Shu'ba and he asks him, hey Shu'ba. He didn't know how to ask with respect. He just called him, hey Shu'ba, teach me hadith. And you know, ulama back in those days, they wouldn't teach hadith straight away for anyone. No. They would see if the person is qualified to receive hadith or not. So he said he was drunk and he was wearing extremely reddish gown, which is makruh in our religion, except that it has some stripes. Plain red is not at all encouraged to wear for men. So Imam Shu'bah, he didn't like that. He said, go away, go. I'm not going to teach you hadith. So he took out a knife. لأجرحنك. I will stab you if you don't teach me hadith. Then Imam Shu'bah taught him a hadith. Look at that, how a drunkard transforming his life totally into righteousness, to piety. Imam Shu'ba ibn Hajjaj, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, taught him this hadith. Sit down. What's your name? Qa'nabi. Sit down, Qa'nabi, and listen to me. Haddathana Mansurun an Rib'iyyin an Abi Mas'udin al-Badri radiyallahu anhu annahu qal. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, idha lam tastahi fasna' ma shi'it. This is the hadith. You okay? I'm okay. And he stood up. Imam Shu'ba gave him what he needed. The hadith of Rasulullah, it meant everything for him. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِ If you don't feel ashamed, you can do whatever you want. You can do anything you want to do. Who cares? If you don't feel ashamed, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِ فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتْ. This hadith struck his mind, made him thinking. He spent a few moments in that holy sanctuary with Imam Shu'bah. He stood up. This is talking to me. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْتْ. If you don't feel ashamed, you can do whatever you want to do. He walked to his house. He met his mom and said, Mom, tell my friends who are waiting for me, I'm no longer their friends. Tell them to go back. I'm not going to be a drunkard anymore. I'm going to learn hadith. I'm going to Imam Malik ibn Anas rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. I want to learn hadith. I want to be a better person. I want to repent. I want to do tawbah. Now, Ka'nabi is not only a good person, he has transformed all the way from a drunkard into Imamul Hadith. He is known to be a scholar of hadith. It didn't take too much. One hadith. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْتْ. The same for Fudayl ibn Iyad, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. One verse of Quran transforming the life of the entirety of a person. Fudayl ibn Iyad was a burglar. He was a robber. He was a thief who would steal the money of people of the travelers and caravan. When at night, Fudayl ibn Iyad, when he robbed a caravan, he was jumping off a wall, he heard an old lady reciting this ayah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alam ya'ni lil-ladhina amanu an takhsha'a qulubuhum li dhikrillah. Alam ya'ni lil-ladhina amanu an takhsha'a qulubuhum li dhikrillah wa ma nazala min al-haqq. He immediately said, Bala qad ana ya Rab. Bala qad ana ya Rab. The lady in her house was reciting this ayah. Alam ya'ni lil-ladhina amanu. Isn't it time for those who believe? An takhsha'a qulubuhum li dhikrillah. To fear Allah. Isn't it time for them to be conscious of Allah? Wa ma nazala min al-haq. Is it time for them to ponder upon the verses of Quran? How long they're going to be wicked persons? How long they want to be doing this reckless acts? How long they want to be doing these immoral activities? When they would repent to Allah, isn't it time for them yet? Fudayl ibn Iyad, immediately striking this ayah into his brain, he said, Bala qad ana ya Rab. Yes, oh my Lord, it is time for me to change. And that was one ayah transformed Fudayl ibn Iyad into Fudayl ibn Iyad rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our gathering tonight, be transforming, be inspiring and changing ourselves into better people by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I conclude here. We are entering to the official ceremony of this program. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.